matching funds have been given in for the SRE.
There's still one thing, and I'll address that under old business here, if I may. No, the SRE still has one more payment, and the processing of that is with Michael Baker. And I'll get into that just a bit further, if I may.
Yeah, again, I'll get that breakout and make sure everybody gets it.
Yeah, it's just put together because of that's the way the city on this one does it.
Right.
Okay, other than that there that Larry wanted some information on, which Keith can look into for us.
You know, one other point on that, not to cut you off, but one other point on that is, as always, it may say 35,000, but we have commitments to grants and stuff, so.
That is correct.
Don't assume that that's all sitting there profit.
We have earmarked money.
Yep.
For the audit. We also have earmarked money for the two projects that we're working on, grant funding this year. And so that's what that is. Okay. So with that being said, if there are no further questions, may I have a motion for accepting the treasurer's report? Gail?
I'll second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. That's what I probably should have said before. But, okay, so the motion carries. Okay, we'll have the interim manager's report now, which Keith updates us on operations, fuel sales, and whatever other things we have going on.
Okay, manager's report 4/9/2019. The runway's in good shape. We have identified a couple of cracks. Jim Kuhn came to me one day and pointed out one that we should probably get addressed as soon as the weather changes, and I agree with him, and we'll get on that. For the most part, it's in good shape. The equipment is one thing I do want to tell everybody that we need to focus on this year is painting. I've got to get lines painted and numbers painted on the runway. They kind of told us that was, they marked it as good, but they'd really like to see those painted. So sometime this summer, I'll get on that and get some help and launch them.
I was given a name today that could help us.
Okay.
We can talk
good.
About it later.
Good. The equipment's in good shape, really. No problems there. Fuel system is working okay. Knock on wood, haven't had any problems. We are in the process of working on the upgrade to get that changes and improvements made. That's in motion and it's going well. That will happen this year. So we're working on that now. Like I said, we selected an engineer and we're working closely with them, and that's going very, very well. Fuel billing, I did the billing as usually do it right at, try and right, do it right at the first day of the month so that everybody gets accurate information. 100 low lead, we sold 138.1 this month, and jet, we sold 230 gallon. So we have a balance of 100 low lead of 3,900. And a balance of jet at 4301. Buildings, really the only problem I've had with any of the facilities is Don was the thing that prevents the snow and ice from falling off. The new SRE building is broken loose on one side.
Snow guard. Yeah.
Snow guard. We've identified that. We informed the contractor and he said he'll be out to fix it first. Don't think it's a real big deal. And the other thing we did is we had a problem with the toilet in there, so I replaced all the guts in the toilet, and it's all good, so.
Okay.
Brought it up to speed. Next thing, I guess, would be the sewer project. We got that completed. It's done. It's I think it turned out very, very well. And I watched rain run off, and it actually works quite well out there. And I make problems with pooling or ponding, it seems to be working very well. So we can put that to bed for a while. The last thing I did this month, in addition to the normal duties around here, was prep. I did all the prep work for the 2018 audit. We got all that put together with Don's help, Tammy, and that's all up at the auditors right now. Don was kind enough to deliver it for us, so next step is to wait to see what they may need out of us in addition to what we've sent. But we sent a lot of information, and so they should be in good shape. And I'm waiting for that call. That's everything I have.
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
How is the crack that was repaired with the help of the city doing? It's okay? I mean, we did that whole.
Out here?
You said the crack in the middle.
The two big ones.
Oh, you know.
That was the experiment that we were.
I think I've checked it several times, and it seems to be fine. We have a couple of places that chipped off because of the snow pop.
Yeah, I flew about a week ago, and it seemed great.
Yeah,
so Larry, do you think that concept may work for us then?
Well, I think you gotta wait a couple of frosts, but
yeah,
so far,
yeah.
So good, yeah.
Good.
Only question, the heat, what's the heat portion of the jet fuel?
I can give you the exact amount if I go into full power, but it's somewhere right around 1,700.
So he hasn't used any for quite a while either, huh?
No, sir.
No. Okay.
Since you brought that up, is there a requirement that we can have him draw that down, or is there a deadline on that?
I don't think so.
I think
there's a contract, but I don't know what's in the contract exactly, other than that it's his fuel, I think, was the purpose of the contract. He paid 25 cents a gallon to put it in there.
The airport authority got paid on delivery?
Yeah, I don't know. You'd have to look at the contract. It might be a date he has to get it out, but I don't remember it being in there.
I don't think so. I have a copy of the lease.
Yeah.
It says he can take it out for whatever reason as he wants to.
My thinking, Don, is that if we do get fortunate and sell it down to that point, we could probably kick the ball in his court and say, what do you want to do to refresh this?
Mm-hmm.
Or,
well, the advantage is that we've been selling some jet. We've had some corporate come in here.
We have.
And they've fueled up, so.
Yep. Yeah, so it's around 1,700 gallon.
Okay. Is there any questions for Keith on anything he's presented here?
Yeah, how are you going to fix the crack? You said there's one present that you're going to work on.
Going to work with the city on that and do probably a similar thing to what we did last year. That seemed to work, and until I see something else better, newer and better, I think we'll just stick with it. I think it's going to work fine.
There are a couple techniques for sealing cracks. Sometimes I think it depends on how wide the crack is and the aggregate or the structure beside it, in other words, how sound it is. In the case of what they did here, Mr. Man Ross, was that like a 2 foot wide swath that they cut out?
Yes.
So they cut out, the city cut out a 2 foot wide swath on those two 70 foot ones, which I call them chasms because they were dang near 14 inches wide serpentine across there. And so they, in that case, it was large enough that they tarred it in to seal it. They put hot asphalt into it, rolled it down, and then let it set, and they came back and they sealed the edges of it. So what I think could happen is there are other methods that can be done. They had a previous method that the airport authority used. I don't know whether that's applicable or not. Or there's others that could have some kind of a sealing material that could be drawn down through there, like you've seen that they do on asphalt on the highway.
Yeah.
And there is a sealing machine that the city has, and I don't know if that would be applicable or not. And I think this is basically what Keith is alluding to. There are a couple options, and you need to, which I think is fine, is to check with the city and see what the best approach would be.
There's I think we can probably safely say that just blow and seal it in a crack and forget about it won't work.
No.
So there needs to be a combination of sealant and aggregate. And there's a new system out that the state of Pennsylvania just sent me a notice on.
Yes.
That's pretty impressive. And I'm kind of excited about it because I think it might be the answer for us here.
And Keith did show me that. I know we're digressing just a little bit, but he showed me that. And if there is somebody around here who would like to take and demonstrate that thing, I got a crack for you to take and demonstrate it on. So, I think Keith is going to try and pursue that option if that's available.
It's almost like a walk behind snowblower. puts crack in, smooths out at the same time. It's kind of neat.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Then is there a motion then to accept the manager's minutes as reported?
So moved.
Okay. Okay. And is there a second for that?
I'll second.
Okay, Heather. Thank you. And so carries. All in favor?
Aye.
See no nays? Okay. Old business. Where we go on to this here is, as Keith mentioned earlier, and I just wanted to update you a little bit on the SRE building, the final payment. In last meeting, I think I addressed it. I think it's addressed in the minutes, but if not correctly, I'll say this. I thought in January that I got two pay applications from the contractor. It was pay app number 6 and pay app number 7. So what it came about is that both of those pay apps couldn't be paid at the same time. Why is that? Because pay app 7 is the final payment. That's where we typically have in grants like a 5% holdback until project is, you never pay everybody the whole thing. So number 6 was paid out, and that's what you saw, the $23,000. Mm-hmm. Number 6 is paid off. Number 7 needed to be justified by the contractor with a bond. So therefore, Michael Baker had to contact the contractor to get a bond, so we have our warranty bond for 1 year. And he needed to get that information. So that has delayed this. So payment 7 is in the process with a holdback. And there was a little bit of an overreach on the thing. We talked about this with LED lights and things. They're working on that, which we all approved that. And I've not got the final payment back, total payment. It's going to be somewhere around $17,000 or maybe $18,500, something like that. It depends where they finally do this. So I am looking forward to getting that very soon. The state had also taken sign off this thing here that they were accepting. The state engineer came up and reviewed this, and we did all of the legal beagle stuff that all goes on with grant projects. So anyways, that's where we are. I'm expecting to hopefully hear soon so I can go into dot grants and move pay app 7 forward, but it's not there yet until Michael Baker finishes their work and allows me to take and move it. And then the state will take and pay out the final money, as well as our small amount, which is a few thousand dollars. Our match. Okay. As also stated here, too, is the audit status. 2018 is at Felix and Glockler, and they have all the audit materials from 2018. Keith put together all the invoices and receipts. Tammy took care of the minutes. These are some of the things that they like. I got bank statements and some other things. It's been a war. And so I happened to be going to Erie that day, so I just physically delivered it to Buzz and talked with him. And he's excited about getting this completed and on time for us. So if, as you remember, there was $4,000 that was set aside and you all voted on for payment of this audit. The 2019 audit, because the city is handling the books, will be done through them. Okay.
Hey, one thing, Don, on that.
Sure.
Larry had asked me or reminded me that we needed to keep track of fuel, and we did include that report this year with the audit. We hadn't done that in the past.
Oh, that's correct.
We put all the inventory throughout the year and the times that we...
What had happened prior before, correct me if I'm wrong, Keith, is previous audits, okay, to Felix and Glockler, okay, we're looking at the fuel as assets. It is an asset,
yep,
to the airport authority.
Yep.
So that's what they did this time. They looked at that. Keith gave them the dollar value of what's in the tank and stuff like that. So that's looked at as an asset to us.
Well, it's been like that since 13.
Was it?
Yeah.
Okay.
They restated 13, 14, 15,
okay,
16.
I started doing it every month.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But there was a question on the last audit.
Well, they didn't have, they had to recreate the numbers was the problem.
Okay.
Yeah, but,
okay.
Yeah.
So anyways, very good. fine with that, and so now we come into, is there any other old business that you folks have that I may have missed? I, like I said, I put this together as a tentative thing. Anything on the table that you think is open?
Just a question about the cameras and stuff. That's old.
The cameras? Here's where we are with cameras. I looked into some cameras. I looked at something that was pretty inexpensive at like the Harbor Freight thing. I've been advised maybe that they may not be what you really would want to have. So I've looked at another camera, which is a little bit more money. Actually, it's a little bit over $500, which we bargained for. I'm in the process of trying to see if I can get a better discount for that. If you wanted to have professional cameras put in here, okay, you're talking near the $2,000 mark, which I don't think that we can afford, and I don't think that we really need that. I will tell you this, that a couple reasons for the cameras, okay, is one, is we aren't here as often, but I need to take and be able to have a camera on the fuel island. When we get to the point here of having 24/7, we need to know what's going on, as well as we need to, which was not addressed before, I mean, it had been noted on previous aviation inspection reports that we needed a remote shutoff to take and meet NFPA 407. So we need to have a camera there in case somebody pushes the button on there. It's just a security type thing, because now if somebody arbitrarily pushes the button, it isn't just it's a lockout push button. So in other words, you push it one time, it's down until somebody goes and resets the whole system, okay? Right now you just have a pound switch that you pull back up and it resets it. The thing that makes it so it's not really a good legality right now is that, assume that you had a hose that was displaced and the fuel was pumping out, and you just pushed this pound button, and then somebody accidentally pulled it back again. Whatever condition that it was in, it'll continue to do that. It'll start pumping fuel again. So consider if you had a fire or something like that. So this here is going to be addressed with our fuel farm upgrade, so we'll call it. We're going to end up having that put on there. And so it'll be now the proper safety for our aviators and for all that use that facility. So the cameras, I'm not dodging the thing. I'm looking at that. It will happen. I'm just trying to find the best bang for our buck. Soon. Okay. Seeing that there's no other old business then, other than that, and I thank you, Gail, for bringing that up. New business. We went through the engineering selection process. You know, we had a committee. Okay, the committee was of Mr. Brownlee, Mr. Van Ross, myself, and Mr. Nickerson. I was not able to say Mr. Nickerson's name at the last thing because I did not have his permission to take and make that known. This is a professional courtesy that I offer to all. Until I have your permission, I don't make that public. And he said it would be no problem. So that was our committee that we put together. The process that we used in doing this for the engineering firms is typically you need to have at least three firms that you go through and interview. What we all did is parts of a process. The first part of the process went through and we interviewed engineering firms with the we called them and asked them if they would be interested in our projects. Okay, we told them what the projects were. Talked on the phone for at least 40 minutes with some of them, and told them what we were looking into and would you be interested? And they said yes. So we got to three firms that we went through. Then what we did is we created a questionnaire and we sent it to these three firms. The questionnaire, as you can imagine, would be what experience do you have with the projects that we have at hand? Ways that we could evaluate them. They, all three, sent back their proposals, the question, answers to the questions that we had provided, as well as we also asked them for references. So then another day we got to meet, the committee got together, and we called their references for these three companies. And we looked at anything and everything we could have. Like one person has some fuel farm work done, another one had obstruction grant stuff done, and we asked them how they felt they interacted with these companies and what were the strengths that they had. So as you can imagine, it was a very, very thorough evaluation. Then we actually called them, each one of the firms individually, and had a question and answer period. The question and answer period was to be, is if we happen to have one or two questions from, let's say, that came back from the interview process and or from their proposals that they responded back to us, as well as it was an opportunity for them to ask questions of us. And it went very well. Keith thought it was very good. So when we got done with this, and I'll tell you this for the record, the three companies that we interviewed was Michael Baker, GAI, and L.R. Kimball. We sat down and reviewed all our notes, and we did this as with the guidelines that are given to us by the FAA. The FAA has a process. And we ended up checking and picking L.R. Kimball. L.R. Kimball happens to be in the area with a couple projects. They're willing to work with us, very eager. We met with them today again. And we're looking forward to trying them out and see how this all works. So we're very happy about this. I talked with the Bureau of Aviation because I had to notify them of who we picked. We didn't have an engineer selected. The last engineer selected was for the SRE building a few years ago. And this is why we had to go through this process. And we will probably go through that process again next year, but we're giving the Kimball group right now this information. And the BOA was very pleased with our process. They thought it was very thorough.
So the BOA has been notified that Kimball...
Yes,
is
correct.
Okay.
Right. The Bureau of Aviation, which is a division of PennDOT. and so, in fact, I was supposed to have a conference call with the engineer from the Bureau of Aviation. He was unable to make it, so I had my conversation with Mr. Hood from Kimball, and I wrote an email later on to the engineer, and he says, no problem, sounds like you, and I explained to him what we talked about and everything. He says, sounds like you guys know what you're doing, so it was very good, and I appreciated that and the trust that they have in us.
Tom, the other thing too is we made it abundantly clear to the other engineering firms that don't give up on us because we have a lot of projects.
That is correct. We did do that to each and every one, and I explained to them that there are other projects coming through. This is only for this year's projects. We have other projects that are in JSEP, which goes from anything from marking the pavement to resurfacing to a later obstruction phase, another second phase on that, because those obstructions always go together. For people that may not understand that in the audience here, is that a tree growing can be an obstruction. Believe it or not, the telephone pole across on Route 27 right now is considered an obstruction, although years ago it wasn't. And what has happened is Larry, being also a pilot, understands the fact that now you have GPS and these precision approaches, therefore they widened out the approach. So guess what? Now, what wasn't a couple years ago is today an obstruction. So those are the two that we're working on here, is the fuel farm and obstructions this year. And like Keith said, we gave the other folks that we haven't picked for next year yet. So we'll go through another round. They still have opportunities. Okay. I put this thing on here, a lease arrangement, because it's been brought up before, and it's a matter of it isn't working, and it's a matter of fairness. And what we have here is we have a an aircraft that we had a hangar lease arrangement with a aero club, and it's been 8 months since they, and part of the agreement was to take and have, you know, some volunteers to help out and stuff like that. It hasn't happened. There is another aircraft in there that is paying its rent every month. It's not fair that these others don't pay their rent and they haven't provided anything. So I would like to make a motion that we terminate that so-called freebie lease for work, volunteer work, and that the that we can send a letter to the flying club and say, listen, guys, you know, you gotta start paying this. Well, I think it's $75 or whatever a month is the hangar lease.
That's what we're charging,
right.
Mr. Wilson. Yeah.
I think that's a good idea. In fact, I'll make sure that they pay the $75, so I don't think it's going to be a problem. Just send a letter to Gales, the president.
Okay.
And we'll take a vote on it. And
well, Larry, would you like to make the motion then that we proceed with that then?
No, I wouldn't.
I'll make a motion that
okay.
We terminate the lease and send a letter that I'll second.
I'm going to oppose.
Okay.
And
okay.
Can you tell me, Mr. Bean, where is the place to mail this letter?
1757 Buxton.
And Tooth Fairy also gets a copy.
Yeah. Who's the Tooth Fairy?
Well,
oh, he, that's also the address.
We send the field copy.
So it would be TACY in care of Gilbert.
Titusville Aero Club,
yeah.
Incorporated.
It's a good address. I know that because I send that address to Bill and then send his money back.
Okay. So Tammy, I have a memo that I can write up, and we can process it. So, yes, Gail.
I would like to add, and I've made this comment, I don't know, several times, once to you, I think, and I talked to Keith about this just a while back. Some of the reasons why you haven't had any help, just in my own case, I can't speak for anybody else. As I told you both, your hours aren't my hours, and for me to come over here when there's no one here, it's a waste of my time. It's going to be mowing season now. I'm going to get on the tractor and mow, do things. If we can work something out so we can get the equipment out,
right.
then I'd be happy to work, help.
What?
Go. But I'm not the only one that's got that same problem.
Okay. Last year, early on, I know, and I mentioned this several times, and I'm not trying to be a dead horse, please, is the fact that Keith, as the manager, is going to be the guy that does the scheduling stuff. So if anybody is interested in wanting to volunteer some time, because Rod, I really want to see us get to the point that somebody doesn't come out here and have to spend 8 hours doing the mowing, that maybe we can have multiple people, that somebody who has a couple hours to afford, they can get part of it. And then the next day, somebody else has got a few more hours. And that's what I'd like to see happen. So in closing on this one here, Gail, I would just like to say, call Keith, 827-0400, leave a message.
Or my cell phone's right on the door.
And cell phone's on the door. Okay. If you're interested in doing that, then Keith can take and make arrangements with you.
Yeah, if somebody has a desire to come out and help us out, we'll work it out.
Okay.
That's easy.
So just one point of clarification, and it really doesn't matter, except to make a point of clarification, is I don't believe the lease has any requirement for hours. So. So I think your comment that there was it was for prior services, and that's why I had a limited period on it. But to avoid just a whole hassle and the whole thing, you send a bill, and I think I'm pretty sure it'll be taken care of.
Oh, sure.
Okay.
I have no questions about that. I just think it's a matter.
No, it's not a matter. That's a. If you want to say fairness, we could have a. It's just a matter. It's not have to do with fairness. If you start going on the fairness route, that's very subjective.
I know, there's a lot of subjective things in this world.
Okay, so I wouldn't go with the fairness route.
Okay, well, let's just say it's the right thing to do. Okay, we have a show of hands. We have a motion already on this thing.
In favor?
In favor. All in favor?
Are you yes?
Sustain.
Sustain?
Yeah, sustain.
Okay, two of sustain. So it's three to two abstentions. Okay. Thank you very much. Okay. BOA and FAA update. Where we are with this right now is that the city, as everyone is aware, has been taking care of some paperwork for us. They have also asked to take the operations and stuff like that over. And they have received, and I've been shown this, the permission from the state and also from the FAA. So therefore, I would like to take and say, okay, that's we've all been knowing this, and that's where this was all going to head to. I'd like to introduce a Resolution 1 of 2019 that basically says it's the termination of the 2003 Airport Authority lease with the city of Titusville, as well as the dissolution and the termination of the Airport Authority. So, is there a motion for that?
I'll make that motion.
There's no discussion of the motion, or does it come after?
After.
Thank you.
Okay. Heather, is there a second to that?
I'll second it.
Okay, Tammy?
Now, hey, this motion is for canceling the lease and dissolving the authority.
That is correct.
Okay.
So, we can open this for discussion. I will say this, that there are some open things going on here, such as the audit officers. It is my impression, I know that it will be my, how I'll handle this, is that we will volunteer our services if the city needs any assistance in addressing any issues for that. And so, yes, go ahead, Clary, do you have?
I just wondered, that I didn't know, you guys know more obviously about rules of motion, but is that proper to just bring up a surprise motion? I mean, doesn't that have to be on the agenda? I wasn't aware we were going to be.
Well, that's what here was the BOA and the FAA update that I had.
It because doesn't sound like a proper introduction to the agenda. But.
Well, I'll make it proper. It is, it's then we are going to discuss then the termination of the 2003 agreement and also the dissolution of the Airport Authority.
And my recommendation is, as long as you get a letter from the FAA and the...
I have seen those letters.
Okay. No. So if we have one, then what can we do? We should vote. No sense of arguing.
Okay. Is there any other discussion on that?
So the letters are on file with City Hall.
City Hall has received the letters because City Hall, and basically, I was shown, has filed for, as you may remember, the assumptions of grants, which basically means all assets. The Bureau of Aviation, the Federal Aviation Authority, okay, agreed to that all assets that belong to the airport, current Titusville Airport Authority, can be transferred over to the city of Titusville for operations. That means the funds that are in the kitty, okay, the bank account. It means the buildings. One of the things would be is, well, let's say the SRE building, okay, it's still not paid over, okay, the final payment. But the FAA and BOA are aware of that and they know that it's going to be paid, so they have also evaluated whether the city can manage,
mm-hmm,
and whether the city can afford.
Okay.
So
as a closing, I'd like to just say, as a secretary here, as a closing chapter, I'm going to request that someone from City Hall forward those.
We will get those from the CO, I promise.
I just put them in the notebook.
Is there any liabilities that go along with that assumption? Would they?
The standard liabilities that we have right now.
Yeah, I mean, not just the assets, but any of the.
The liability is to come over, like we have the liability insurance that we paid at the end of December, okay, and that covers us all.
But don't you have some assurances or guarantees on how it's gonna be used over a period of time? What are those things called?
Like all the equipment stuff, Larry?
Right, I mean.
Yeah, that all stays, right?
Oh, yeah, no, the, one of the things here is that, if this is what you're alluding to, Larry, is we know that certain equipment here is airport equipment, okay, and that was purchased for airport use.
All equipment.
All equipment, that's what it still stays there. It's not going to be dismantled, moved anywhere else, it still stays here, operating the airport as we have done before.
Yeah, and I'm not familiar with this, but isn't there, I mean, you can't, with the amount of funds that we've gotten, there's no, you can't make this into a non-airport use facility and those kind of things as well, right?
No, the, they are, the, from what I read, what was shown, is that the city has agreed to take and maintain this as an airport.
Right.
There is no.
Yeah, I used to keep my airplane up at Wattsburg, and Tom Mountain owned it as a personal thing, and when it closed, he wanted to sell it to the waste disposal people.
No.
But he couldn't because he had a term that it had to stay as an airport, even though it was closed, he had no rights.
The FAA and the Bureau of Aviation truly understand that this is still staying an airport.
I'm sure it's all legal, I'm just.
Yeah.
Well, in fact, that's the reason.
Well, the letters came from the directors of the Bureau of Aviation, also one of the directors of the Federal Aviation that I saw, they were signed on. And so, they said, there's no problem, they have absolutely no problem with the city handling this, so that's where we are. So I guess.
Call a vote?
Yes, we can call a vote if there's no more discussion.
Mr. Walden?
No.
Heather?
Yes.
Mr. Frazier?
Yes.
Myself, yes. Mr. Bean?
Yeah, no.
Okay, well the ayes have it, thank you for your vote. I think this will be a good thing, we have already seen better record keeping and other good things that are coming about.
I'd like, on the better record keeping, to get a confirmation from the auditors that there's better record keeping than.
Well, that will be next year, yeah.
No, I mean, at this point in time. You're saying there's better record keeping going forward or going backward? I didn't understand your comment.
What I'm saying is that everything now is funneled down to the city. So
okay, so that going future is going to be better record keeping.
Correct.
Okay, thank you.
Starting January 1st, Larry, because I know that you missed the meeting. January 1st, all the stuff has been going to the city.
No, I'm sorry. So
whenever, and I'll be detailed here. When Keith receives any money from fuel or somebody gave him a check and stuff like that, he has to take it down to the city. The city goes through the city process, the treasurer, and it's all recorded through that way. If we happen to, let's say, buy toilet tissue, or we went to the hardware store and we had to take and buy a part, it has to be signed properly and all these other things and certain codes applied to it, whether it was considered maintenance and all these other type of things. So I guess what I'm saying is they have a Munis system that some of us are aware of that does all the figuring and everything else, all the financials for the city, and that's the same concept as being done with the airport authorities. I will tell you this, that some people I've heard saying, oh, well, the city's just raiding the airport authorities' money. That is not true at all. I've been promised, I have no reason to believe any other way. I know that money is earmarked in those accounts for these projects that we have, and that's it is there to take and run as an airport. So it's not going to be fund balanced into something else. So
I actually have no concern that was going to happen myself.
I'm just stating.
I don't know who the people are that are concerned.
Some have, yeah. Larry. You know how the rumors get worn on a small town. So anyways, okay, with that being said, I happen to have no other further new business. There will be we will consider termination as of effectively the close of this meeting. There is no other meeting. If for some reason, okay, the city requires us to get together, we will have some kind of a special meeting if we all have to get together, and we'll be all addressed that way. So, is there any other comment from our folks here at the table? Yes, please.
I just want to say, Don, that I'm out here to make the place better, and if I'm selected to be a part of it going forward, which I don't know the answer to that, I'm going to continue down that same path. With that said, anybody needs anything out of me to make that process better, to make this airport better, I'm all ears.
Since we advertised, all future meetings are going to be happening on the second Tuesday of the month, etc.
I will talk to the solicitor and see where we need to be with that, whether we need to send out. There will be most likely termination advertisement that will probably address this. This is just I need to get the proper advice for that.
Thank you.
Okay. So I've got a little spot here if there's any public comment.
I have a couple of
Okay, Mr. Elliott.
You were talking about security cameras and that you could get commercial ones for $2,000. Is that, would that be airport owned or would that be through a commercial service?
That would be airport owned, but that's more money than I really want to. I think it's beyond what we want to do. What we want to do here, Jim, is just to monitor some things, some ins and out activities. If we happen to have any vandalism, that's what it's for.
Why don't you guys use Canada Lake security? The city already uses it for the fake gas station.
Because
Titus alarm works.
Because the expense there.
Do you know what the expense is for them to come in and do the airport?
$2,000.
That's a $2,000, okay. Just my question. I thought you were purchasing them for yourself, not, you know, hiring somebody to do it.
No, let's just say I've been doing my homework.
Yeah.
And evaluating these things just to make sure.
Okay.
That we, but I don't think that we need something that I can see a fly on a, or a deer tick on the other side of the fence either.
Yeah.
So.
Maybe you could get a rich donor to pay for it. That would be nice.
Well, we're working towards things like that.
Yes. Then I had a question about resolution number one. That was what you just did there.
Yes.
It wasn't on the agenda, as Larry said.
Well,
is
it's
that
sort
sim-
of on the, but
is that similar to what the state did with the East Main Street home? Where they just come up with a resolution, there's no other voting on it?
We're not addressing that.
I can't answer that.
Well, you're on city council, you would know.
Well, I'm wearing a different
hat. This is an accounting
meeting.
Okay. And then also, I see that you have a voice recorder there on the table. Is that through the authority or through the city? Or is that privately owned?
It is just so Ms. Champion can take and record the
minutes. Is it Ms. Champion's herself?
It's this.
Is it the city's or the authority's? If it's the city's or the authority's, it really doesn't matter.
Then
I just figured if it was owned, listen, hold on a second. If it was owned by the city or the authority, then it would be available to the public. That's my only question. You can't answer?
I don't have a comment for that.
You can't tell me who owns it?
I don't think it's worth it because you already said what didn't
matter.
Yeah,
Bob giving you a name.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any other comments from the... Okay.
I'd like to know if my pension's going to come up now.
Your pension?
Sure. I don't have a pension for being on the authority all the time.
Absolutely.
Oh, jeez.
Right up. It'll be here the third Saturday.
You're
not the mayor.
I can tell you how many people accuse me of getting paid. Yeah, right. So, anyways. Okay. Motion for adjournment. It is 6:50. Heather, is there a second to that motion? I'll make the second for that. Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so we're adjourned at 6:50. Thank you very much, and I do appreciate all the help and cooperation you've given us.
hire your attorney.